Executive saloons come in a variety of shapes and sizes. You get those large, blocky, squared-off versions that seem like these massive slabs of granite just wafting across the road, unperturbed by bumps and undulations. Then you get the sporty bunch. Now these ones mimic the styling of their two-seater brethren from whichever manufacturer they originate from. They seem considerably more nimble, more agile, considerably more sporty than those big squared-off blocks. Now both are going to offer you fantastic levels of trim, fantastic opulence, massive interior space, finished in aluminium and leather. It really is an opulent affair, fit for CEOs or private bankers. Audi's A7 range falls into the latter category, the sporty ones. It's a Sportback, so it gives you this two-door coupe styling, but it has four full doors and four full seats. You got to think Mercedes-Benz CLS here. Now step it up a notch and you're going to get the S7, which is even sportier and it has the performance to match. Check a couple of the options and you're going to black out all the chrome, you're going to get LED headlights and of course a styling set of 20-inch wheels. The interior is, of course, something to behold. It is a full leather and brushed aluminium affair. The seats that we have here are the Valcona leather seats. It is an optional extra, but they are cross-stitched and they have the S7 logo embroidered into the back, one-piece backs, tombstone seats, very nice. They do lack bolster adjustment, so they don't support you as much as what you'd expect from a sports vehicle of this nature, but they are lovely and comfortable. Interior space is also beautiful for all four occupants, and they're going to sit comfortably as well because it has four-zone climate control. It allows them to set their own temperatures at the back there. Now, being the S7, it is a little more sporty, so you're going to see racier dials with chrome surroundings and chrome rings. You're going to have stitched steering wheel, nice and thick and chunky, and of course the pedal shift for the S-tronic here at the back. It is a lovely, lovely interior. The drive is fantastic. With the air ride suspension, you can also raise or lower the body as you need, as you feel fit, for whatever the conditions, but it absorbs the bumps, despite the fact that we're running on the optional 20-inch wheels here. Oh, it is a great place to spend some time. It's quiet, comfortable, convenient. I like the fact that you can hide the infotainment screen. You no longer feel like you're driving your sitting room with this massive screen in front of you. It feels like you're driving a car game. It's great for day-to-day driving. And that is, of course, till the sun goes down. Here where it comes alive. 331 kilowatts, 550 newton meters of torque from the 4-liter twin turbo V8 motor. Turbochargers resting in the banks, boiling away, spooling up, creating an absolute menace. With addictive linear acceleration, shifts as quick as lightning from the S-tronic 7-speed gearbox. And of course, the beautiful growl and the beautiful roar through the almighty exhaust. It's powerful, it's hungry, it's a Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. It's a wolf in sheep's clothing. It's the monster that lurks underneath your bed. It is a nightmare on any street.